Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today returning to Planetbase. We have a lot of work to do. The mine has most recently finished construction, and I'll zoom in to let you get a little bit more of a detailed look at it. We're going to start sending in our workers to dig out resources that are going to then be transformed here in the processing plant. So right off the bat, we're going to lower the walls and add some processing facilities, metal and bioplastic. Remember how last episode we were working on growing some starchy plants? The pea pad has just been built, so those peas are going to start growing and then being turned into bioplastic for us. So we're gonna get one of each, the metal processor and, okay, that sounded really close. Where was that? That was just feet, mere feet away from the dorm, could have killed two or three of our astronauts soundly sleeping within. That's terrifying. We're gonna need that asteroid shooter before long. So while we have these two processors going in, that's gonna give us a temporary method to take the raw materials from the mine and have a place to put them. But we need more long-term storage solutions in the form of a storage facility. Let me see if I can track that one down real quick. I know it's somewhere around here. There it is. It's all the boxes piled up. You know what? Sick bay is going to be very important very soon, too. Their general health needs to be fine-tuned. Right now, they're good, but what if they get into an accident? Who knows? I'm thinking that the storage solution should probably be somewhere close to where most of our raw materials are going to come from. On the one hand, we've got plants being grown. We have to store those somewhere. And on the other, we've got stuff from the mine and the processing facility. So that puts me into a little bit of a dilemma. They're gonna have to walk one way or another. You want your stuff that needs to be stored probably put a little bit closer, but like I said, this is my first colony and I'm gonna make first colony mistakes because it's more fun that way. So I'm gonna place my storage facility adjacent to the processing plant, at least for now, and who's to say we can't have multiple storage facilities in the future? And now I'm curious, what are the different sizes of storage facility? There are three. We're building one of the smaller ones right now. We'll build the bigger bubbles at a later date, perhaps. My happy little robots are taking each of the boxes and stacking them up to build. And that's going to give us a new location to place all of these crates. We got spare parts, medical supplies, some meals still left over, and of course a bunch of raw materials. I'll hit Alt so you guys can see what we have left up at the top right of the screen. The sun is coming up. Let's check on our electricity issue. We got about 3,000 watts, units, whatever you want to call them. And I'm starting to think again about redundancies. We added a new way to generate power. Look, the wind completely gone. Perfect timing, sun. You're coming up and the solar panel will do the rest, I think. Still technically 0 out of 30. I guess the sun is not high enough and it will rotate to follow the sun. Just a neat little detail. So I guess it's tracking where the sun is in the sky at this very moment. Let's queue up a new outdoor power storage device, and I want to make one that is a bit bigger than the others. Power collector. So we've got... that's hefty, hefty power storage. But you know what? Power storage seems really important. What do you think? We'll go medium. We don't need to skip straight to huge, do we? No. Medium it is, and I'm gonna build this one fairly close to the power collector. I don't need to spread everything out as far as I can, but I don't know. I kinda like having these longer hallways. Looks like our storage facility is now done. The connection has been built, oxygen flowing in, and I'm not sure if we have to build anything in here. We do not. There's no way to customize the storage building. They're just gonna start taking resources in here, and hopefully there's enough room to buy us some time on all of these potentially disintegrating resources, specifically food. I don't want the food to spoil and go bad. Speaking of food, I believe it's being hauled over to the meal maker now, one by one. And occasionally, you can see this producing. So we've got a few meals stuck in here and some raw vegetables. And as they take more and more of these, they'll stack them into the meal maker and it will actually process the vegetables into meals. I like watching all the little pieces work together. It looks like our first raw materials from the mine have been brought out and our metal processor is now being worked on by Anne, the worker. We're making some metal out of ore. Okay, so it's just gonna take ore out of there. Pump, stop exploding right next to my face. It's really freaking me out. We need more power and we're well on our way to storing that power in the form of this bigger power collector, medium size. Since our solar panels work so well during the day and it's guaranteed they're going to work, look at the wind. The wind's almost non-existent right now. It's slowing down to a crawl. I would love a medium solar panel, but I really want to squeeze a solar panel in here. And unfortunately, I think only the small one will work. All right, good enough. We'll hook you up here, and that should hopefully take care of us in the short term. Now, we are going to continue breaking even. I was going to say storing up power, but now it looks like we're actually on the decline. There's zero wind. So, this solar panel is going to come here at the right time, I think. Seems like our robots are breaking down more and more frequently of late. No engineers have come out to help. He was on his way to build this solar panel, and he got stopped in his tracks. Maybe we need more colonists. Maybe that's the problem. We don't have enough workers to spread the load. We are starting to use the storage facility, which is cool. Our carrier bot is just permanently on duty here. Ooh, did I see the bioplastic processor working? I did. Unfortunately, the worker is going off to do something else right now, which is fine. It maintains the progress for later. Power storage is low, yes. That's gonna, yeah, look, oh my, look how fast that's depleting. The wind is starting to kick back up just ever so slightly. It could rescue us in T-minus 5, 4, 3. Okay, my counting was off, but the power is now out in the entire colony. Power collector is currently completely out. The wind, very slow, about 23 meters per second. Not really good enough. We're gonna hear that clicking on and off quite frequently, I believe. The buildings that are closest, oh, this is one thing I did correctly, that are closest to the power supply are the ones that are gonna be powered first. So the extremities go off initially, but see how the oxygen generator is closest to the power supply? Now, if the wind had kept up, okay, that noise is gonna get obnoxious, then the oxygen is still going. You see what I'm saying? So even though this looks dire, at the bare minimum, I'm allowing our people to keep breathing because I smartly connected up the power supply first to the oxygen generator. See, I'm not completely incompetent. Some of you may be thinking, Etalyx, even with the wind at a fair pace, you're not producing any positive power. Okay, I agree. You're right. That is why I have skipped small, I have skipped medium, and gone straight to a large wind turbine. That's right. Now we should start seeing a little bit better increase, but of course we need a connection before this wind turbine does anything but spin its turbine for just fun's sake. And the power outage sound continues. All right, anybody? Are you gonna come over here and construct this for us? Hilda, the engineer? I bet you are. Let's speed this up to 4x speed so this engineer quickens her pace. There we go. The wind turbine is hooked up to the grid, and we're going to start seeing the power collectors with the addition of our newest solar panel start giving us a little bit more of a backbone when it comes to making sure that we don't go bust for electricity. With the power problem out of the way, I think it's safe to start work on a new building. The sick bay is going to become a necessity, an infirmary to treat colonists. This is a dead-end structure, similar to the dorm. You cannot hook up it. Don't tease me like that, game. You can't hook it up to any hallways. See? All red. So if I put it over here, this is going to instantly become a dead end. So I'm probably going to attach it and maintain the pattern that I have been accidentally creating. But you know what? I kind of like it now. And hook it up to the biodome like this. And of course, as we expand further in this direction, I can open up some new airlocks to allow our people different ways to get in and out of the base. I'm not 100% certain what the sick bay is good for, besides obviously healing. What I'm trying to say is, if a meteor hits somebody, do they insta-die? I assume so, but maybe the explosion can strike them if they're just too close, and they can go get healed. Or maybe their general health just goes down over time, but everyone that I can see appears to be full-on health. Why can I not click this person? There we go. Yep, full-on health as well. But either way, the sick bay is done. There's only one customization here, the beds, but you still choose how many beds you need. So even if there is only one customization for certain buildings, I'm kind of okay with that for the simple reason I still have to pay some of my precious bioplastic. What if three people get injured at the same time and I only have one bed? You gotta roll the dice a little bit there. It appears that someone has had an accident. There's a broken bone laying in the sick bay right now. Maybe I do need another bed. You know what? Just to be safe, I'm going to add a second sick bay bed. Okay. So I did that just in time. We would have had an injured colonist who wouldn't be able to work, and now they can be healed. In fact, the medic, the Clan Keys, is bringing some healing supplies over from perhaps storage or whatever's left of the ship. How do we make more medical supplies? I bet we're going to need some kind of factory to create processed goods. A lab, maybe? Lab produces medical supplies and grows synthetic meat. So we've got a few objectives to accomplish, don't we? On the one hand, I really want a landing pad to start getting some new colonists here, perhaps. And on the other, I really want a processing facility to make sure that we've got a lot of medical supplies right now. I think we'll be okay. Let's do the landing pad. That sounds like the most fun, right? Get some ships flying in here. I want it to be close to the front airlock, right? And we can hook these up even to dead-end buildings. Sandstorm. Wait, what? What does Sandstorm do? Is everyone gonna be able to get inside? Security controls? Hang on, I gotta study. So if you have a security center, you can set it to yellow alert so that colonists stay indoors and medics, there's guards that go on duty so that you can keep them inside so they don't get hurt. You might need to activate guards against intruders. And then there's red alert. Colonists will try to attack any intruders even if they don't have weapons. That's just like, I didn't know there were intruders. Okay, I've learned something today. We do not have this magical security control center. Maybe we should hold off on the landing pad for now. You know what? I'm not even gonna queue this up until the sandstorm is over because I don't want anyone getting hurt that doesn't need to get hurt. I don't want some dummy going out. Oh well. Don't want some dummy going outside to Clan Keys, the only medic that we probably have in this colony, to go like build whatever this dumb building is that I want to make. Where are you? You're really fighting hard here. He's got his arm up over his face. He's moonwalking a little bit. But he had to go get those medical supplies, by golly. They were important. Just let the carrier bot go get it, okay? The dust storm appears to finally be subsiding. One of a few different types of natural, I wouldn't say disasters, but certainly dangers. A meteor would be a much greater threat, I think, to our colonists. But it probably does increase the chance people getting injured, for example. We're going to go ahead and place the launch pad that I wanted. Putting it next to the dorm, not so considerate for our colonists. I'm trying to sleep over here, but the planes are trying to land. Yeah, that doesn't seem like ideal positioning, but nonetheless, too bad. Deal with it. Eventually, of course, you can give them their very own cabins. So the dorms are communal, but they enjoy cabins a little bit more because they got privacy. But yeah, as far as disasters go, don't really know what else is out there, but it's fun having them just randomly occur and trying to deal with the consequences. We'll get the security terminal up soon so that we can control when our colonists go outside and hopefully eventually get some guards on duty as well. I hope you guys enjoyed this video on Planetbase, still finding that there's a decent amount of things to do. Again, don't know how long that's going to last once I've constructed every single available building, but I hope you guys stick it out with me for at least another couple videos. Thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Etalyx. I'll see you next time with some more Planetbase.